rest for the wicked. We should hurry.
I suppose Ceridian's magic died with her. These specters are getting more aggressive.
Antea, I miss you.
There's that voice again.
Ignore it. Push on.
I'm talking to you, little sister.
Sister.
What aren't you telling me?
I'm telling you it's dangerous and we need to move on.
Void feels even more dangerous. That's possible.
Not gonna ask for help? Hogging all the fun. Trouble's about.
My father would tell me stories. In the heart of the mountains lived a mystical race who desired only peace. I can hear him now. These mystics, he said, valued life and used gold only for their mausoleums. All creatures were accepted among them, except the men who were warned to stay away. Bellicose and greedy.
Let me guess, they went anyway.
Aye, being bellicose they did. And being greedy, they went after the gold. Their mausoleums desecrated, the mystics cursed the humans, and hid themselves away. And they remind me of Ceridian, who would rest her.
I think a way to pass could be near. No, this isn't good.
You see anywhere that could help?
Keep searching here. The spot can't be far. We need to look for somewhere to cross. Try to find a way across.
I'm on it.
That's almost it. We need to look for somewhere to cross. Help if you need it. Don't let that specter get to the port. According to the map, the treasure should be near.
Must be rich in ore. Looks a bit rickety.
It's built for a team. One man alone should be fine. Should be.
Won't budge.
A tangle of rope work locks it up.
Thank you.
You can't climb, but I can get us up there. Not a pleasant way to die.
Not a pleasant way to die, is it?
more rope and it's done. I bet it's up there. bet it's up there. One more rope and it's done. I bet it's up there. The lift should be freed now.
These beams look fragile. Will they hold?
Would you rather climb?
If it were up to me, I wouldn't be here to begin with. Climbed higher, or has the weather gotten colder?
The nightmare is at work. She's likely using the weather in New Eden to further isolate its people.
And once the curse is lifted, the snow will disappear.
I think so.
Did you hear that?
Yes. Nearby. Wasn't your first. Won't be your last.
Aye, thank you.
See these body parts? Good place to manifest what may linger nearby.
Picking up something spectral nearby.
You've excelled of late, and you haven't crowed about it once.
And your doubts, did you?
Don't get cocky. There's always more to learn. Key thing about a scourge?
A scourge is made of many specters merged.
Not always. A harvester, for example, is a scourge born of a single specter. A scourge will always seek a new physical body, often made of different materials. Very poor. Perhaps you'd prefer an easier question? On the nature of the ghost, perhaps?
Ghosts have ties, objects through which they're bound to someone living.
You are the opposite of Charles. Good at the practical, terrible at the academic. I hope it's enough.
Do you hear that?
Over here. Peaceful place. In different times.
Before the nightmare's influence, you mean?
Let's reach the fort, and a fire warm you up.
Who's that?
Yes. Something's here. Trouble ahead. Specters are attacking the fort. change targets. Tormented first.
Ow! When have corpses this hard? They're putting up a fight then.
Hold there. None in, none out. Not living nor dead.
Name's Red Mcraith. I'm obviously a banisher. Open the door there. I've business within.
Your business is, if you'll excuse my articulating the evidence, not my business. I have my orders. You can't come in.
I hear you, friend. What's your name?
Name's Andrew White. You seem a pleasant fellow. I like a Scot me, but standing here, I'm on duty. And when I'm on duty, I'm not your friend. Listen, mate, folk in here have problems enough, and I can't be disobeying orders. Either Preese or Pennington would have my guts, and I fancy neither.
Pennington knows me. He'll know I can help.
I'm sure he does. But put one dead man down, and three come back next day. Round here, sweet victory fast turns bitter. Bottom line is, the captain is indisposed, and I'll not add your complications to the pile. Now, you want to lend a hand? Mrs. Preese and her party are overdue. You can't miss the outpost, it looks out across the valley. If you could find her, make sure she doesn't die, you'd surely gain her favor. And favor, as they say, opens doors.
Get in a fight and find your boss and dig her out of whatever hole she's in. All right. I can do that.
They have specter troubles. Let's first clear the nearby nest to relieve the fort, then deal with the missing.
How holds the fort?
How holds the fort? Precariously, that's how. Our strength dwindles, and we'll soon run out of powder. Priest took Williams and that other fella. And off they went, scavenging for supplies. They've not yet returned.
It's dangerous out there. The scavenger may easily become the carrion.
Heard any good scuttle lately?
The dead are coming, and you want to gossip. I admire your sang-froid, and that's the Lord's truth. But now, sir, is not the time.
Right. I'll likely be back.
Find our friends, Banisher. Or put them to rest.
I'll try. As soon as I take care of the Spectre's nest, I'll go looking for the outpost.
Death knocks at their gates. No wonder they won't open.
They don't have a choice. Another attack may overrun them.
The nest might be near. There's a trail to follow in the snow. More coming.
Come and get your breakfast, boys.
Oh.
folk will run out of powder.
These pests don't spring from nowhere. They never learn, do they? That's it. That's the place. Fill in the hole. Bury them all.
I should buy the fort a little time.
Let's hope it's not too late for the famous Mrs. Preese.
Ah!
I wonder how many there are in the fort.
Fewer by the day, I'll wager. Still, better to be in the sight than out.
Did we miss a few? The mountain is awash with specters.
Did the foraging party really come this way?
That would explain why they haven't returned.
Something's nearby.
Where is it?
What is lurking here?
Time to work, Banisher.
Is that?
Yes. Something's here.
Nothing's concealed. Something's nearby.
Where is it?
Something spectral nearby. It's concealed.
Looks like you're walking.
Looks like. Aye! Something's here.
Hidden. This one's not been dead long.
Let's hope he stays that way.
If there's a survivor, they're not here. We push on.
Looks like they were taken by surprise.
Doors blocked on the other side. Now would be a good time to speak a few words of power, just to be sure. This isn't over yet. Move yourself! Watch out! Specter position!
I raise, for now, the Veil of Shadows.
That's not the ritual I'd have used.
Turn out and turn up!
Present yourself! Get back up!
Standing by.
Something's nearby.
Where is it? No, we need to find something else.
I feel something close. The heart's yours. The roots are mine.
Yes, just how I like it.
I'm not going in there unless I have to. No need to go down there. Well, I think we're done here. Let's go back. I'm not going in there unless I have to.
Watch out! Specter possession!
this on.
A timely arrival. You'll be Haskell's banishers. Thank you. Thank you both.
You can see me?
Clear as day, just as I can see. This is my husband. I am Helen Preese.
Antea Duarte. This is my partner, Red Mcraith.
It is rare that the living can see the lingering dead.
All I know is one day I woke after 7 long years of grief, and my Sebastian was back. It was as if my prayers had at last been answered. That was enough for me.
In times of danger, I am duty bound to protect the woman I love. You understand?
What was it like for you? After my own death, I floated outside of time, without knowing what was happening to me.
Floating outside of time? Yes, that's exactly it.
True love finds a way. That's all that matters.
Andrew White sent us. He thought you might be in trouble. Plainly, you needed your guardian angel.
We needed more than one. Thanks to you, we'll resupply the camp. Matthews and Williams did not die in vain.
This was a risky expedition. Helen had no choice. If the survivors were to rely on Pennington alone, the fort would have already fallen.
I suspect that's so. Sometimes difficult choices must be made. That's courage.
All the courage in the world will be worthless if those in command won't match it.
Pennington did this while monsters relentless besieged the fort. But make no mistake, these men's deaths are on the captain's conscience. If he has one.
How so?
7 years ago, a plague came to New Eden. Pennington quarantined the sick in the mines, walled them up. They were dark times. Hard times. None knew what the morrow would bring. We all lost much. Too much. As second in command, Sebastian volunteered to stay. Walled in with the others, he held out the longest. He died a hero. And now the Forsaken are rising. They demand revenge.
Who would blame me? I watched them die. Soldiers and miners, sick and hungry, begging for help they knew would never come.
Captain Pennington has much blood on his hands.
I'm sorry. You've been through a lot.
We have. We are, and will persist till we prevail.
We should get back to the fort. We will escort you.
I'm afraid I locked us in when I broke the latch.
If there's a way out, we'll find it.
Yeah.
Lock looks broken. I doubt that gate will ever open again.
I can make short work of this roadblock.
Impressive. You banishers are quite something.
I saw her. Just the help.
A banisher marched with my father's infantry. Good for morale, he said.
Soldiers usually carry their ghosts with them. War is good for our business.
I take it that's how you met. And I was a soldier in the same fight.
I never worked for the army, but something like that.
But he's no longer the same man.
What would you do in his place?
I'm doing it. He sits behind his walls waiting for them to fall. And I'm out here fighting to live. We're fighting for our lives. The captain is in the way.
These internal conflicts are a risk for the stability of the fort.
A necessary risk for the survival of all. But I agree. This must end. You may send someone back for them.
Yeah, the path should be quiet. We cleared the area of the Spectre's nest.
That's belief. Follow me. Go talk to Pennington. Make him understand, if you can.
Where can I find him?
He hides in his office. I'll find him there.
Where are the others? Williams and the other chap?
Matthews. We were ambushed. They fell.
May God have mercy on their souls.
There's ammo in the elevator. Send Shepard and Abbott to bring it back.
Good to see you living, sir. Keep it short. I'm on duty.
How are folk doing? Fighting fit?
They're farmers, most of them. Shopkeepers, house servants, hunters. We've one old soldier, but he's sick. Them who stand dead on their feet. Fighting fit, my arse. But we hold against the hordes of the dead. Now, leastways, the fight's not fair, is it?
That's wrong. We're doing our best to put it right.
Wherefore the paradise of New Eden, eh? What a hole we've made of it. Mind you, if we stop digging, we die.
Had any good scuttle lately?
I'll spill it if I have it, but be quick, I'm busy.
We've known an officer or three, you and me. So, tell me about the captain.
In nigh on 20 years' service, I've not met a commander more efficient. Nor one so relentless. Ever a pain in the ass, aye. But a good one. But that was then, and this is now. He's not the man he was. Still a pain in the arse, mind.
What think you now of Helen Preese?
Well, she's like her husband. Only yet better. Command is in her blood. She reminds me of my old mum. The Queen of Topsfield Common, we used to call her. Born to give orders, she was. And you dare not disobey.
Did you know Sebastian Preese?
I surely did. Good man. Hell of a soldier. Had kingly ideals, but did not strut like a crow in the gutter. Hero is an ill-used tag. Oft misassigned. But Lieutenant Preese was a hero, and a proper one at that.
Peaceful watch to you. Good day to you. Miss?
I'm the Hunter Flora Abbott, and I never miss. You?
Tis rare, but I've been known to miss. Red Mcraith, Banisher.
I heard about you when you first arrived. Is your friend not with you?
She died. She's with me in spirit.
Sad to hear it. I have nothing clever than that to say. If you need anything, well, probably can't help.
So you hunt for the fort? Are you part of the train band?
I serve, in my way. Before the curse, I traded with the people of New Eden. Meat and fur, bartered for whatever they had that I needed.
How did you end up in New Eden? You won't mind me saying that you're not like most people here.
And yet, I'm a New Englander. Born on a farm not far from Boston, but always preferred the wild. So I came to New Eden. In time, I came to love it. It's cursed, and I'm still here, aren't I?
What do you know? Tell me about your day-to-day.
If I did, would you listen?
Talk to me of Captain Pennington.
I've worked for worse. I'm able and I give him no trouble. In return, he makes sure I get none. He respects me. That makes him an excellent judge of character. Don't you think?
What can you tell me about Helen Preese?
Not my favorite person, if I'm honest, but in the fight against the dead, she's an asset.
How are you yourself?
I do my work and do it well, though few notice.
I'll take my leave of you, Flora.
I'll not stop you.
Pennington.
No time, no way out, no hope, no way in. Time at all.
Captain Pennington, sir.
Mr. Mcraith. Live.
There's work to be done.
Work? You had work. A mission. To bring one last glimmer of hope. To gladden our hearts before the pit takes us all.
You secretive bastards haven't helped.
The job is done. There's no more hope in little enough time. All that remains is the pit.
Surrender just yet, Captain. I found Helen Preese. We brought supplies.
A waste of effort on both accounts.
Hardly. We saved a life. Resupplied, we may save more.
For the sake of what? For the sake of days? A week, perhaps? You've saved no one. You've prolonged the terror. The dead will come. Our throats will feel their bony fingers soon enough. The end is inevitable.
It is if you will not act. You're the officer, take command. Surely you can't intend to do nothing.
You sound like Preese. She has changed. Her return to Fort Jericho has made her impulsive, irrational, quarrelsome. I believe she did not fully grieve her husband's loss. Returning to the scene has, it seems, reopen the wound. It festers. She'll join the lieutenant soon enough. When our defences crumble at the last, the pit shall take us all.
How do things stand, Captain, as you see them?
Little has changed. The dead flood from the mines. We shoot them down and gain respite. Soon, the onslaught begins anew. The clock of our extinction ticks on towards the hour. We may no more defeat the dead than we may vanquish the ocean waves.
Folk have little enough hope, and you're leading them further into the darkness.
I've heard the whispers, the murmurs, the plotting from the shadows. We hold to the last. We resist till retribution rises from the pit and drags us all to hell.
Well, that's something worth waiting for.
I fail to see the appeal of this slow agony.
How unfortunate. Because thanks to you and the time you bought us, the agony will be all the slower.
Fair to say your tactical retreat from New Eden Town has not served you.
The town was doomed to fall to the curse. We disagreed on everything. There was nothing left to do but leave. We did not know there'd be no escape. Newsmith gathered the bold and the governor that they feared flocked to him. We never agreed on anything in the first place.
The Newsmiths are holed up in the woods, planning soon to leave for Boston.
They may leave for Boston, but the curse will follow. The curse will follow until their backs are against the wall.
The governor is no more. His son takes charge. They rebuild as best they can.
Little Lammy Haskell. Truly.
Well, better him than his father.
May the vacuous peacock rest in peace.
As the commanding officer, you must know all the local lumps and bumps.
The lumps and bumps can smooth themselves. I have other priorities.
Why did you come to New Eden, Captain? Why here?
Far from the many wars we fight, you mean. I had shot enough Frenchmen and more than enough Indians.
Did no one come with you?
Keep to your business, son, not mine.
It's just, there's a portrait hanging on the wall. A family.
I had a wife and daughter once. Once. I'll not entertain you with their story.
Tell me more about yourself and your career.
I did my duty and had the fortune to return alive. That's all. We who are intimate with war tell no tales.
I thought that too. I was wrong. Silence allowed my ghosts to prosper. It is good to tell our stories.
If ever I do tell, I'll not be telling you, son.
Permission to take my leave, Captain.
And if I refuse it?
Are you trying to recruit me, Captain? Do you really think I'd take the King's shilling?
If I were to offer enough shillings, I'm sure of it. I need no new lieutenants. But if you wish, you may stay. This key unlocks the unused watchtower. You'll build it while you're here.
Captain, beaten by the world. On the other, his rival, haunted and mutinous.
In a fort besieged by vengeful specters.
Behind all the shit, there's something else. Something darker. Could be worse. The underground. Thank you.
Banishers. May I have a word?
Helen, something wrong?
Apologies for disturbing your rest. I'm afraid it can't wait. What did you think of the captain?
I saw an officer alone. A proud man turned to stone, perhaps, by years of war. I saw a broken man.
I did not see the tyrant you described.
Inaction is tyranny. He will not act, but nor will he get the hell out of the way.
I do not disagree, but the captain needs help.
I too was a soldier, broken and haunted. With Antea's help, I recovered. Pennington may need the same.
Leave Pennington to me. The good folk of the fort need your help. You are banishers. The dead, you'll have noticed, hammer at the gates. I would like you to go into the mines and find out what enrages them so. I would like you to do what the captain will not.
And while we deal with the hordes of angry specters, what shall you be doing?
When the mines are purged, I'll oust Pennington.
Where do we go?
There is a second tunnel into the mines. The entryway was walled shut during the quarantine. Getting there will not be easy, but the barricade should fall without too much difficulty. After that, who knows?
Underground again. Wonderful.
If it soothes you, I too am taking a significant risk. The captain has a penchant for locking people up and leaving them to rot. Some years ago in New Eden town, the captain locked up an innocent woman. A fate I wish to avoid.
Pennington the jailer. Do you speak of Deborah? What did he do?
I was away from New Eden town at the time. Rumors said she was a witch, I later heard. And so too did the captain. The court agreed. Who knows what urges drove the captain then? He is a secretive man, and always has been.
How goes it with Sebastian?
I'm not sure. I had never let go of my grief. I was bereft. Empty. His absence gave me substance. I clung to it. Useless, really. My husband died in the dark, with nothing but my handkerchief to soothe his last moments. And now, he's back. If each worthwhile thing in life is to be lived, and then when it is gone, to be grieved, then what now? I have to believe our love is enough.
Love is hard work. We are bound to grieve all the different versions of ourselves. And theirs.
I try to hold him and cannot. It taunts me. It was almost easier when he was gone.
All things are fleeting. Gaze upon the ghost you love and you can't deny it. Bitter though the thought may be.
Yes, 'tis a blessing and a curse. Yet against all reason, we persist. Let us make the most of time remaining.
Is it your belief that Pennington's quarantine lies at the heart of the problem here? That this is why the dead rage so?
What else? He walled them in. Miners, nurses, soldiers, the healthy or the sick. He buried them all, and then he lied about it. I'll brook his callous cowardice no more.
Much goes on around here. You seem to know about all of it.
I try, and I could do something about it if the captain was out of the way.
What brought you to New Eden?
I came with Sebastian. Willingly, mind you. My father was a soldier. I knew there'd be travel. Sebastian courted me for 3 years. I swore when we married I'd follow him to the end of the earth. And here we are.
How's morale about the fort?
The fort has known better days. Not many, mind. It's always been miserable. Folk deserve better. They fought so hard and lost so much. The captain must show them a future.
We should go.
Then it's agreed. When you're ready, you'll investigate the mines. Take the hoist to the waterfall, near the outpost you first found me. From there, it is not far to the tunnel. Keep your wits and all your luck about you.